Nobody puts baby in the corner. Okay, this, it's that line that everyone remembers from Dirty Dancing. And what the heck is that all about? What's so bad about sitting in the corner? I mean, I kind of like it. I mean, it looked like it was a pretty good view of the stage from the corner, so I don't know what baby's complaining about. Personally, I like sitting in the corner when I go out. You're totally not in the way of the waitstaff, and it can be kind of cozy also. So what's Johnny's problem with her sitting in the fucking corner? Settle down, boy. Settle down. But I guess we finally got me to read a funny opening from that movie. I really needed to get that one out. Feel much better.
Would you like to learn from those that are taking their lives, their businesses, and their passions to the next level? Best-selling author of Speakeasy and master connector Lou Diamond is here to connect you to some of the most inspiring and amazing people on this planet. Get ready to thrive loud with Lou Diamond.
Welcome, everyone, to another spectacular episode that's going to knock you off your socks here on Thrive Loud with Lou Diamond, connecting you to the most inspiring and amazing people that are thriving each and every day. I'm your host, Lou Diamond. Today on Thrive Loud, we have the founder of Entreprenista, Market, Socialfly, and Pearl Influential Capital. Yes, I just said four things right there. She's been a leading social-first digital influencer with awards to back it up, while helping build some of the fastest growing private companies, and has worked with hundreds of major brands and businesses. She is the co-author of Like, Love, Follow, the Entreprenista's Guide to Using Social Media to Grow Your Business. She is also the co-host of the Entreprenista podcast, a rock star program, which you will start listening to after you learn who she is on this episode today. Thrive Loud listeners and viewers, I am so excited and absolutely thrilled to bring Stephanie Cartin onto the program. Stephanie, how are you today?
I am doing well. I actually slept last night. I have a little one who likes to keep me up at night, and I actually slept. So I feel great. I'm so excited to be here and connect with you and your listeners.
She's recharged. She's revived. She's ready. And as you've heard, she has an unbelievable story of entrepreneurism here and entrepreneistaism, if you would you call it that way. So here's what I want to do. I've learned a little bit about you. Let's give a shout out to all of the Cornell Thank You podcast and Michelle and Stephanie, who you were guests on their program. A lot of people will put a link into that episode as well because it was such a great episode. But I know about you, but our listeners here don't. So what I want to do is I want to rewind. I don't want to go all the way back to the womb, Stephanie. I want to understand how this thing that you're doing, this entrepreneurista spirit, kind of started, launched, and where it's heading to. Sound like a plan?
Oh, that sounds like a plan. You want me to dive in?
Dive right in.
All right. So I won't go back to the womb, but I'll go back to early childhood. I always had an entrepreneurial spirit. I think from the time that I first started becoming a brownie and Girl Scout and selling Girl Scout cookies as a little one, and just realizing the incredible feeling of selling something that people wanted and needed, and then becoming a top seller. And I realized over the years, and it took me until after I had started our first business, Socialfly, to realize that as a child, I was always picking up on things that were trending, becoming obsessed with them, and then figuring out how to make a business out of it. So, like I said, I wasn't taking you all the way back to the womb, but pretty close. It's just really been, I think, in my DNA. I think I was a born entrepreneurista, and that's how it all began.
Okay, so let's talk about this entrepreneurista component of what you're doing, and let's start off with Socialfly, which is a pretty amazing company. Help explain to the listeners a little bit about what Socialfly specifically does, its purpose, and where it's grown to over these years.
Sure. Socialfly is a full service social media marketing and influencer agency. And we actually specialize in working with brands that are looking to reach an audience of women. We've worked with probably 300 brands over the past 10 plus years, creating social media and digital strategies for them and implementing those strategies on behalf of the brands that we have worked with. And Socialfly started myself and my business partner, Courtney, because we started helping friends of ours who were starting businesses on the side of our full-time jobs. We were, Courtney and I were both working in the corporate world and taking on clients on the side, putting together these social media strategies. And this is going back 10 plus years ago before social media really was what it is today. We just were on the forefront and realized how important it was going to be for brands. And after working on the side on these client projects for about 10 months, we said to each other, you know, if this is going to be a real business, we either have to go all in and do it or not do it at all. So Courtney and I decided to quit our corporate jobs on the same day, which was May 4th of 2012. And we never looked back and grew and scaled our agency business organically over the past 10 plus years by doing great work for our clients, being referred to new clients, always practicing what we preach with our own marketing strategies for our agencies. And as you had mentioned, we started winning awards for our work. We were on the Inc. 5000 list for a few years in a row. And that's actually what leads to how Entreprenista began.
Yeah. So that and perfect. Let's go right into this. First of all, I love the word Entreprenista. Kind of talk about the whole beginning of that and how you like, what was the thing that lit the match that got you started to say, wait, this is an avenue we also have to pursue?
What started to happen was because of the quick growth and success of our agency business, women started reaching out to us literally every single week, wanting to go out to coffee and pick our brain and really just wanting to hear how we were able to grow and scale our agency business. And what you'll learn about myself and Courtney is we are the type of people that like to help absolutely everyone, but we started to realize it was actually physically impossible to go out to coffee with everyone who was reaching out to us. So we started thinking, you know, how can we help as many women as possible, but do it at scale? So that was our aha moment. We were like, oh, why don't we start a podcast? We'll share all of these incredible stories of women that are building these businesses and have so much insight and advice to share. So that's what we did. We launched our podcast called Entreprenista at the end of 2018. And it really just took off from that first episode. And from there, all of 2019, Entreprenista really was just our podcast. And we were organically growing our social media community on Instagram and our email list. And then fast forward, you know, 2020 happens and obviously the world changes and we're now getting messages from our listeners and followers. We're hearing things like, I lost my job during the pandemic. I want to start a business. Can you help us? Or I need to pivot my business. Can you help us? And Courtney, here we are. We're like, oh my gosh, we have to help all of these women. But the only way to do this and to focus on this is going to be if one of us actually focuses on it. So Courtney and I decided in 2020, because we have been, you know, best friends and business partners for many years, and we know how to divide and conquer, that to build out Entreprenista to be what it is today, which is a full media company, membership community, and now podcast network, one of us would need to really focus on this. So we decided Courtney would continue to focus on growing and scaling our agency business, Socialfly, and I would work to build out everything with Entreprenista. So that is how it happened.
Okay. And I love it. I love the ability to recognize who could do what and who needs to do what. And you have an amazing program. We will put all the links for everybody to go check out this great program. I love asking podcasters this question. I'm going to do this first. We're going to hit the podcast and then we're going to talk about the message that kind of came out of this podcast. And that is that there is an unbelievable gift that you get while sitting in the chair, the one I'm sitting in now, not the one you're in, the one that you're normally in. Can you share with the listeners what you have been able to gain and just cherish from being the host of the Entreprenista podcast?
I just got the chills when you asked me a question because it has been the most incredible opportunity and gift to get to talk to some of the most accomplished, inspirational, and resilient women over the past few years. And not only having the opportunity to hear their stories firsthand and get to connect and meet with them, but then the opportunity to share and tell their stories and have their stories impact other people, it has been the most incredible opportunity that I could have never even imagined when we first started our podcast.
Do you think, I was going to ask this question, and it hit me the other day because someone asked me this question. So now I get to relay it. By the way, I'm bottling what you just said. When someone asks me the gift that I get, I not only have to speak to women, I get to speak to men too, you know, which is a good and a bad thing here or there. My question to you is, do you think that the skills that you have had being a podcaster have helped you grow the other businesses and the other brands that you have been doing, but you probably didn't know that that was going to happen? Is this true?
It absolutely has. It has given us an additional platform and opportunity to be able to reach and connect with people through our Entreprenista podcast that we might not have been able to had we not started the podcast. So absolutely, yes.
Like, love, follow. There's one thing when you get to create a podcast, but there's another when you actually get a chance to co-author a book, which is obviously Entreprenista's Guide to Using Social Media to Grow Your Business. I don't know what came first, the chicken or the egg here. Was the podcast first? Was the book the next thing? Tell me the order of that and what it was like to write down this message that you have, which is a gift to everybody else, you know, that people could pick up their shelves or listen to, whatever it might be.
Yes. Well, fun fact, we wrote that book in 2015, and it is hard to believe what year we are now, 2023. So almost a decade ago. And what's actually very interesting is a lot of the information in that book, or most of the information in that book, is still extremely relevant to this day about social media. I think some of the screenshots were outdated from Facebook in 2015, but all the principles of how you need to strategize to use social media to grow business and build community connections is all still very relevant. And Courtney and I wrote that book because as we were scaling our agency business and starting to work with larger and larger clients, we could not always work with startup founders based on how we were scaling our agency business. And we still wanted to be able to give women entrepreneurs who were first starting their business really the guide that they needed to think about as they were figuring out their social media strategy. So we wanted to get all of that down on paper for these women who are starting their businesses. So again, we're always thinking of how can we scale the knowledge and information that we have to help as many people as possible? Because in an agency business, you can really only help a certain number of people at a given time. And the only way to scale things, like we've talked about, is through podcasts, through books, through content that everyone can access. So it was definitely helpful from an agency perspective to have written a book, because when we would go into new business meetings, we could share, you know, we've written a book on social media, and there is, you know, validity and credibility when you've done so.
I want to know, by the way, we have to figure out a way to combine philanthropy and Entreprenista together, because your genuine kindness in being this Entreprenista and helping others, whatever that word is, we're gonna patent it. You and I, we're gonna figure it out afterwards, and maybe too many syllables, but we'll try and break it down. I do want to know that with all of the stuff that's going on, and I said to myself in my notes here, I said, Stephanie, I have to ask this question if the conversation goes down this way. To your point, when you first started out, social media was a lot different than what we're dealing with today. I want to talk about today because, you know, I would actually argue there's a lot more bad rap type stuff that social media can get versus a lot of the benefits and good that it can create in helping to build a brand, a business, connect, make the sales, and the aspect of growing what you need to do for that medium. From an expert, from somebody who obviously helps companies do this, I don't want to give like a whole state of the union of what's going on in social media, but I want to hear the biggest hurdles and challenges that you face in both, you know, from helping with the Entreprenista podcast brand to all the brands that you have underneath you, that you're seeing that is kind of the hurdle and the little hot spots that you're dealing with today. I think our listeners would really appreciate it.
I think one of the biggest challenges with social media today is that there is endless opportunity of content to be created. I'm talking about from a brand perspective. And if you don't have all of the resources, it's like, how do you figure out what to do first? Do I need to jump on all of these new platforms as they come up? Do I have to be on TikTok? Should I be pivoting my entire strategy to Instagram Reels? It can just be so overwhelming for people to really grasp, because it's not like it was when it first started, when we were managing, you know, Facebook and Twitter accounts for brands. And then Instagram came about, and then other platforms that came and went. And it's just a lot. And I think that is the biggest challenge, is really just figuring out where should you focus as a brand, what's going to make the most impact. And it really just all comes down to strategy and then budget and bandwidth for a brand.
I'll let you know that, you know, I'm really getting better at all the TikTok dances that I'm trying to develop for my brand. Just to be clear, I'm really good at them. No, I'm not.
But it's so hard, right?
Here's the thing. Like, you know, I actually like the TikTok dance, which I joke about, because we actually do have a TikTok account. And if you would have told me that 4 years ago, and not even knowing what TikTok was, I've said, no, we're never going to do that. I think what every brand ambassador, and I use that term, that could be, you could be the person representing other brands, or you're representing yourself in the social sphere. The challenge is not only managing it, but why are you doing it? Where is your audience? Who are you trying to connect to? And there are the multiple channels, to your point, are incredible distractions. When, to give you the challenge, and I'm sure you're familiar with this, on the Thrive Loud podcast, which we are pretty active at promoting and making sure that we get our brand out there, we've learned that to connect the most to the guests who are the stars on our program, we're following where they're most active on their challenge, on their channels, and we will hit that. And needless to say, you know, our range of guests on where they're busy is all over the place. They're not all in one place as it used to be. So from our perspective, it becomes a balancing act to make sure that we're messaging to the audience that wants to connect with the person that we're featuring.
Yes.
And I think that carries over to regular social media management for your clients is, look, I have one colleague of mine, they just do LinkedIn because that is where their world is. That is what they do. And by the way, they're really good at it. You know, everyone says, oh, are you on Instagram? Or are you on this? And they're like, no, this is where we are. This is where you could find us. And for them, it works. And I think it's definitely challenging when you have to manage both of it. And I imagine this is where my question was going to go. When you have to manage your personal branding for the Entreprenista piece, do you drink your own Kool-Aid? Do you follow your own steps, or you stick to the plan that has worked for your clients?
Yeah. It's challenging even for people that are in the business and in the industry, because at the end of the day, you need the resources to be able to execute on all of these places. It's not so easy as just taking a video and whatever you post on Instagram, just go send it right over to LinkedIn or TikTok, because it has to be formatted properly. It has to be the right messaging for that audience. So back to what you were saying, and what I share with people all the time and members of our community, is you need to determine what your goals are, why you're using social media, who are you looking to reach, where are your customers, where is your audience, where are they spending their time? And that's where you need to focus. And for platforms that you decide are not the right fit, my recommendation is you want to set up an account across all the other platforms. So at least you have your domain on that account and you own it and you have a presence, let's say like a landing page. So if someone does look you up on another platform, that you exist and you can let them know, you know, find us over on LinkedIn, on, you know, an Instagram page or grid, or on Twitter. So people, if they do look you up, those places can go direct over to you. For Entreprenista, we're very focused on Instagram, but we are now working on doing more on TikTok now that we have more resources on our team that can start executing there, because so many women business owners are spending a lot of time on TikTok. Yeah. And we want to show up there for them and be there for them. So even though I'm not the one personally executing posting on TikTok, we have a team member who's taking the content that we're creating from our podcast and putting it there. And it's great to work with people who specialize in TikTok and love TikTok and know the algorithms and know what hashtags to use, because that's really key.
Totally. I love asking entrepreneurs this question, but I am even more interested in asking the Entreprenista this question. You have been thriving, you know, since the Girl Scout days, and everything you've been doing from an early age in every aspect in your life and your business and all the passions is just why you're here on Thrive Loud. And your success story is great. We all know, though, that there are days when we're not quite kicking on all cylinders and we're a little off our game. Stephanie Cartin, when you have trouble thriving, what practice do you seek, or maybe which individual do you seek out to get yourself back on the thriving track?
I love that question. And it is so true. And we say this on our podcast, and I say it in life all the time. Things are not always as glamorous as they look on Instagram in someone's feed. Running a business and life in general can be extremely hard. And something that I've personally always done is shared what I've been going through personally and in business so people can really understand that they're not alone too. I went through a very challenging infertility journey and pregnancy journey that I shared through social media to help others and connect. And I tell everyone I would actually not have gotten pregnant or stayed pregnant through my complications if it were not for sharing on social media, because I was able to connect with people that helped me. But something that I always do if I'm having a really hard day, a hard week, a hard time, I have mantras that I just tell myself over and over again. You know, I'll say things to myself like, obviously today is a bad day. Like, tomorrow's a new day. I get to start over tomorrow. And really, like, practicing the things that I preach, I really do them. You know, having a bad day, looking in the mirror and smiling and saying, today is going to be a great day, even if I don't feel it. Like, I do those things.
Love it. Let's do the admin part of the show, because yours truly is very excited to get to Fun Street here with Stephanie. Stephanie, share with the listeners all the places people can find you, learn more about Entreprenista, the podcast. We will put everything in the show notes, but it gets more engagement when they hear it from you.
Of course. So you can follow Entreprenista on Instagram. We're at Entreprenistas, E-N-T-R-E-P-R-E-N-I-S-T-A-S on Instagram and across social media. And I'm personally on social media at Steph Jill Cartin. And feel free to send me a DM on Instagram or LinkedIn. I personally am always on those platforms and responding back to everyone. And for anyone who's interested in joining our membership community, the Entreprenista League, you can head over to entreprenista.com/join.
Spectacular. I love when people who know how to give that message quickly and efficiently. And I wouldn't have expected anything less from the amazing Stephanie Cartin. Stephanie, are you ready to go down Fun Street here on Thrive Loud?
Let's do it.
All righty. Can you share with our listeners and viewers what you shared with me is one of your all-time favorite movies?
Favorite movie is Annie.
Okay, now I assume we're talking about the original Annie, right? Which was original made, I guess, Annie. In like the 80s or something like that, yes. Correct?
Yes, Aileen Quinn starred as Annie in that movie.
Okay, why does that movie connect so much with you?
I grew up doing musical theater, and the first show I was ever in was Annie. I played Molly in Annie. I ended up naming my daughter Molly because of it. I always love that name. And yeah, I've just always loved that show.
I'm going to date myself, and my youngest sister will probably hate me more for it. That was her favorite movie. We had it on a VHS tape that was probably literally worn out from how many times she watched it. And I mean, that music and those songs were playing all the time. And now fast forwarding, my daughter played... She played Annie in one of her theater things growing up, and it was a lot of fun to hear her saying "It's a Hard Knock Life" or whatever it might be. But it is entertaining and quite comical. And when you think about the range and career that some of the actors who were in there, from Carol Burnett to Albert Finney, who were like stars in that movie, how big that thing was, and then they make a remake. Go figure. But it's a great movie. It really is. It's hard not to not like Annie. Who knows?
Has anyone ever given Annie as an answer on that question?
Never.
Before?
This is we need to come up with like a sound effect or an answer. Nobody has picked Annie as the best movie, and I think it's real, because if I ever had my sister was a guest on the show, but we didn't get to the point of what which movie, because we had both sisters on, and Spaceballs was the favorite movie. So, but Annie was probably hers. Anyway, I digress. Okay, let's do the speed round here, Stephanie. I'm going to ask you a few questions. She's nervous, listeners. I can't believe this.
I'm used to doing this.
So let's see how she holds up.
I like to be prepared for everything. So.
Well, this will be fun. I can imagine. I'm starting to learn that about you. I'm going to ask you a question. The first thing that comes to your mind. These are things that lift you up, motivate you, make you feel good. Basically, they make you thrive. Okay. You ready?
Ready.
Of late, a song that you love to listen to or one that pumps you up?
I Will Survive.
Ooh. A favorite food that is not a dessert?
That's a tough one, because dessert is my favorite food. Croissant.
Okay.
Almost a dessert.
What's your favorite dessert?
Apple pie.
Mm-hmm. With ice cream, a la mode, or just plain?
If it's warm, with ice cream.
I gotcha. An activity you wish you did more of?
Walking outside.
An activity you wish you did less of?
Sitting in my chair and forgetting to move.
An activity you recently tried that you absolutely loved that you want to recommend to everybody to go try it.
I started working out with a trainer to take care of myself. That's been very helpful.
Okay. I do agree. They always push you and they keep you going. I'm with you on that. If I could snap my fingers and you could be anywhere in the world, where is Stephanie Cartin?
At the Magic Kingdom.
Oh, she's a big Disney fan. Not too far away from you because you're coming to us from Florida. Awesome. The last piece here, and I never thought about this, the word entreprenista, which has almost a Latina flavor in there, or does it? I was actually going to ask that question, like that particular word.
It wasn't intended that way. No. When we first created it, we were in a brainstorm and we were thinking like fashionista, entreprenista. So that's kind of how it came about.
I actually like it. I like it a lot and it's awesome. And you obviously own every handle of it. You could possibly do go you and taking it. Stephanie Cartin, thank you so much for coming on Thrive Loud. We will make sure everybody checks out everything. Everyone's got to go listen to the Entreprenista podcast. It's awesome. Her guests are really spectacular and inspiring as well. And I feel thrilled and honored that we finally got you here on Thrive Loud.
Thank you for having me. Great to meet everyone.
You got it. And to all our listeners out there, thank you for joining us. And until next time, keep moving onward and upward. And remember, be brief, be bright, be gone.
You've been listening to Thrive Loud with your host, Lou Diamond. Check us out on the web at thriveloud.com and follow us on Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook at Thrive Loud. And check us out on the Good Pods app at Thrive Loud, where you can follow, listen, and connect directly to Lou and all of the Thrive Loud episodes. Thanks for listening.